Welcome to this episode of Take a Look, our new interview series on digital policy in which we take a look at what an ambitious European digital policy agenda should look like. Digital policy is one of Europe's main policies priorities to enhance our competitiveness in the future, our societal prosperity, and protect our values and principles. And with Take a Look, the EPP wants to find out more with you and inform you about the important topics and what our EPP family members are doing in this space. So today, let's take a look with Kyriakos Pierakakis. Minister Pierakakis, thank you so much for joining us today on Take a Look.
Thank you. It's a great joy to be with you.
So you are the Minister for Digital Governance of Greece, which positions you at the forefront of digital transformation, and specifically you're spearheading policies that are driving your country's digital transition and its economic recovery as a result. Now, we know that digital transformation imposed in Brussels for the EU can only work if member states take action, including coordinated action, and perhaps there should be more interaction in the digital conversation with member states beyond the Brussels bubble. Because there are many great examples of how implementation goes in practice in European countries, and Greece certainly is leading the way on many things. So I'm very pleased to welcome you today on Take a Look. Thank you so much again. Now, among the pillars of ensuring Europe competes successfully in the digital economy, there's the empowerment of citizens, of course. There's the digital transformation of businesses, of course. But there's also the digitization and the digitization of governance and the public administration. So you have a digital strategy in Greece. You've set up this Greek research and technology network, and Greece intends to spend 25% of its recovery fund on digital. Can you explain a little bit how you've set all of this in motion and what it says about Greece's progress in the digital transition?
Thank you so much again for the opportunity to speak with you for a topic which is at the core of our interests as an administration. I have to say that digitization for us has been since 2019 for the government of Kyriakos Mitsotakis at the core of our interest, at the epicenter of our interest, exactly because we feel that it can resolve a full spectrum of issues. And I think that we should focus on a specific terminology, which we don't talk about in these terms a lot in Europe, service design. So it's not reality about digital, it's reality about how do you design processes and services in a manner which enables citizens and corporations to interact with states in the best possible way. How to simplify our lives, how to do what the managers call business process re-engineering using modern tools of informatics, something which was necessary, I guess, even before the virus, but it became absolutely essential during this last 1 year plus of COVID-19, where we had to ensure that businesses continue to operate and states continue to operate as well in the best possible manner. In this regard, we created a new organization, a new ministry, which we previously didn't have in such a manner, a Ministry of Digital Governance, which took exactly these functions. So the functions effectively were how to interoperate systems of the public sector, how to simplify processes which don't necessarily have to be digital processes, but overall the processes of the state, and of course the core function of telecommunications and space. And in this regard, we assembled these responsibilities under the same roof. This ministry is an extension of the Prime Minister's office because we understood, having studied other member states and other governments, that in reality, where we have seen this project to be successful is primarily where this project is effectively owned by the head of state or head of government, depending on the system. And we developed a very comprehensive plan, which we call the Digital Bible, which is not just a strategy. Even though we love strategic documents, we find them to be absolutely essential. We found out that what was missing here was effectively an implementation plan rather than a strategic document per se. So in this document, you will find around 440 projects, specific projects, small or large, projects that either need to be procured or need to be implemented by our own capacities domestically or regulations. So we bundle all of those projects together in a single document, in a specific timeline for the next 4 years. And in reality, we're currently implementing a very ambitious agenda. At the core of this agenda, I would place the creation of gov.gr, our unified government portal. We started it in March 2020 with 501 digital services Now we have 1,150 services, a bit more than a year later. So every ministry, every public sector entity, every organization is adding new services to the portal. We developed an application also, a gov.gr application for citizens. We plan to develop a series of other applications and a series of other digital services in the coming months, the most ambitious of which is digital patient records. So each Greek in the coming months will have an application which will effectively be his or her patient records file on the basis of our e-prescription system, a system which we already have, but which we're opening up for citizens. Now only doctors have access to the system. Now citizens will also have access to the system. So I would say this is primarily, I would say, the key tenet of the agenda. The transition to 5G is another tenet of the agenda as well, because we need modern infrastructure in a manner in which it will be deployed as quickly as possible. And of course, we have seen the usefulness of digital, and I will close the answer to the first question with this. We have seen the significant usefulness of digital policies and digital tools in the vaccination system that we're currently, that we have enrolled, which has a dual digital facet, either that of a platform, Envolio, as we say in Greek, a vaccine, .gov.gr, or the e-prescription system, where we reach out to citizens ourselves and we propose the COVID-19 appointment, the vaccine appointment, and two physical facets, in the pharmacy stores or in the citizen service centers, thus having created a unified process, both digital and physical, but which is supported by digital systems, which has a fully digital backend, and this is why we were able to issue the vaccination certificates very quickly, and which effectively gives a signal to citizens of what we plan to do, what we plan to establish in the coming years overall, using this vaccination system, this vaccination platform, as a burning platform of what we were hoping to do overall with the Greek state.
Thank you so much. That's a great transition to the second question. And actually, thanks for bringing up all those specificity that you've lined up in your strategy with, a specific timeline, specific targets. I think this is actually what gives it the agility and the flexibility and being able to anticipate what comes next and integrate it more easily in the system. Now, indeed, you mentioned patient records and this platform, and we often talk about how digital has helped a lot through this pandemic. And surely the countries that already have in place digitalization strategies and policies, they've been able to navigate this crisis better than others. Can you perhaps tell us then a little bit more about how you've instrumentalized this existing digital strategy and how it proved particularly helpful in tackling the virus? I think you started to refer to this digital certificate as well.
Well, we need to begin a year back. I would quote an article written by Yuval Harari in the Financial Times at the beginning of the first lockdown, where what he wrote was effectively that after a couple of years, the pandemic will be over, but what will remain will be the consequences of your digital policies, depending on how you deploy them. Thus, we understood quite early, I think, that digital strategy and digital policy would be one of the key components, both of battling the virus, but also overall for transitioning to a new period. So what we decided to do was, comparing to other countries which focused on tools, which were focusing on other elements, we decided to instrumentalize, as you said, an already existing strategy, that of digitizing the state and digitizing our interactions with the state, the interactions of citizens and corporations with the state, and render it a tool to battle the virus. Because in that sense, we understood that as you're digitizing a service which required you to visit a state guichet or a public sector organization, in reality, by digitizing, you gain limiting interactions. And thus, in a very challenging period for COVID-19, when you limit these interactions, you also gain on another front. You gain on the economic front, you gain on the productivity front, but you also gain on the health front. So we have numbers to back that this was a success in Greece, because I think it's enough to compare how many digital interactions we had, let's say in 2018 in Greece, either directly or indirectly, either through logging in to the state systems or through interoperabilities, through our interoperability center, where the state didn't ask for specific documents, the state obtained them itself. So in 2018, this number was 8.8 million interactions. In 2020, this number had escalated to 94 million interactions, times 11. So this was times 11 in less than 2 years, effectively. Thus, the strategy is quite comprehensive, and this is why it has been embraced by Greeks both in Greece and outside the country. and by the Greek diaspora. And each service that we're adding up effectively touches upon a life event of citizens, starting from the birth of a child and the bureaucracy behind declaring the birth of a child in Greece, which involved five steps up until February 2020. Now everything is done digitally in the hospital, as it should, until the passing of a loved one. In this continuum, you have a full spectrum of interactions with the state. So we're trying to take each one of these interactions, renewing your driver's license, obtaining your driver's license, entering a hospital, enrolling your child in kindergarten, let's say. And we're using simple digital tools, so this is service design, effectively, in order to make these interactions very simple, very lean, and showcasing that the state can act as an enabler rather than as an impediment. Those 1,150 services digitized through gov.gr showcase that this is the case. On other fronts, we're simplifying services. For instance, on the justice front, we took 25 certificates and we merged them in a single certificate. This is not a digital process per se. This is a process simplified physically. We're also offering this document digitally, but in reality, we need to think of digital not as an end, but as a means. And this is exactly what we're trying to do. Now, obviously, we deployed certain tools which were pandemic specific. In Greece, we have been using an SMS-based system for permits for citizens to exit their homes during lockdown, which was a behavioral economics exercise. In reality, you could send as many messages as you wanted, but in reality, we felt that this was a self-regulatory tool rather than something else, but which we felt was coherent with the overall strategy of using technology as an empowerment mechanism rather than as any other alternative. And this is why we feel this strategy has overall been quite successful.
Thank you very much for sharing this great example, and I'm glad we'll get a chance to share it on our network so that more people find out about the great work you've done in Greece. Thank you so much, Minister Pierakakis. I have one quick final question for you. Do you have a preferred or a favorite tech app or tech book or magazine or unicorn company?
Oh, I have to say there would have to be many, so it wouldn't be easy for me to single them out. But as a graduate of MIT, I have to say I read the MIT Technology Review a lot. So I would actually recommend reading it to everybody who's interested about technology. And for us, it was quite useful also to see a comparison of our vaccination system through an article in the MIT Technology Review compared to similar deployments in the United States, either federally or at the state level. There was a quite interesting, I would say, essay on this.
Well, thank you for this great suggestion. And thank you so much, Minister Pierakakis, for being with us today. And we look forward to further conversations with you. Have an amazing day. Thank you.
Thank you.